Why are you hearing this now? Why? Have you ever asked yourself, why are you a minister of the gospel? Do you know that any more time we come for a meeting, I will judge them by the parameters of the flesh? A meeting may be deserted in a visitor, and only one man may be encountered, and after 5 years, that one man can become an army, impacting millions of people in the whole world. And a meeting can be full of thousands of people, and all of them may fall under the anointing. But after 1 year, all of them will pass life. How do you judge a meeting, a successful meeting? How do you judge if a meeting is successful? When 10,000 people gather? No. It's the impact upon the lives of men. It's the transformation upon the lives of men. You don't judge a successful meeting by how much people fall under your meeting. No. And that was it, Gilead and Ehud. That the meeting that he went for, that made him to become born again, it was only one man that preached. Was it Gilead and Ehud? Was it him that was in the story that he went for an outage? And only one man gave birth his life to Christ, and that man became a mighty man today. You can go for a meeting and God will utter only one man. And only one man can be saved in that meeting. And after 5 years, that man can become the reason why millions of people are saved today. I was filled with the Holy Spirit by Gilead and Ehud. But look at me today. Even Gilead and Ehud doesn't mean the kind of people I have touched today. Whether my books or my messages or my or whatever I've reached over to millions of people. You cannot imagine. There was a day I was flying to the east. I was at Abuja International Airport. I saw Gilead and Ehud. I went with him. I had to greet him. I let him understand, this is the man that you people save. They may not have done so much to me, but even saving me was a good journey, was a good contribution to my life. It's a good contribution. And one man can help you to be saved, another can help you to grow, another person can help you to do other things. You don't judge a meeting success in the flesh, you judge it in the spirit. Why are you a minister? What is what people call success in ministry? People call success in ministry when they have cars, they have houses, they are a joker. All of those are not important in heaven, I assure you. So many people believe that they don't have a car, they don't have a house, they don't have relevance in the kingdom. You don't know that many of those comfortable people they will proceed for God. There are a lot of people that went to the level of comfort beginning to come to them in their life. They are genuine pursuit for God change. They went into serving mammon and idolatry. Don't seek to add more car to your life. Don't seek to add more house. Add more God to yourself. When you add more God to yourself, house and cars will come. I have gotten a lot of things today just because more God is increasing my life. And I will get many more things. A man that gives you God is worthy of your everything. When you continue to contact God, God will give you everything. The Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all other things will be added unto you. All other things. Many of us are after all other things, and so we forget the righteousness of God. And the truth is this, if God for truly take away God away from you, then you never knew God before. If a man that is sent to the bush to represent Jesus as an evangelist, and the man does not need a car because in the bush there is no real road for a car, so God gave him a bicycle. And he looked from one region to another, casting out devils and healing the sick. Another man that God would have to send him to Abuja, and he needed the best for the cars. In fact, because his ministry has international relevance, he has to even go to US, UK, so he has a private jet. So sometimes you have to fly a private jet. In our own parameter of measurement, we say the man in the bush is not successful in ministry. Why the man is in successful ministry? The problem with you is that you don't see the business of God. All of them are successful. The man with the bicycle that has to use the bicycle to go and reach out to people in the villages, and the man with the private jet and with a good car that we used to go to use and the rest, all of them are successful because according to the carnal lifestyle of his regulation, God has apportioned him out to US If you bring that man that used to go to US and tell him to come to your village, he may die after 2 days. And the man that is in the village, you take him to US, he may forget that God exists and start living the life of US. So every man is appointed to give a measure of grace to ensure that you represent Jesus. All of them are successful in ministry. There is another man that God might have called him to be in the US, but he's in the village here, suffering here. Okay, leave here and go to the US. Another man may be in the US and he's struggling there. God may want him to come back to the village. Whether the man in the US that was supposed to be here has thousands of members there, he has failed. The one here, he has 2 members and God wanted to be here, he has succeeded. You must understand that when you come to ministry, your success is not determined by many of the carnal parameters you have judged. No. It's not everybody that will be popular in the kingdom. Our popularity is not coming upon the face of earth. There are some that God has set ahead before us. It is true that God may not reveal all his men at all times. The prophet was told that there are many other people that have not bowed their knees to Baal. As anointed, as important, as influential as you are, you are not the only one. God is raising men and women everywhere, just that you have not met them. I say something that no matter how anointed you are, there is a level of audience you may never be able to reach. There lies the relevance of other people that are helped by God. Whether you like it or not, there are people that you may never be able to reach to. Somebody may have to reach them. Those people are as important in the kingdom as you are important. They may not be as influential as you. They may not have 10,000 followers. They may not have 10,000 members of church, but they are also important. There is a generation of people that may never listen to you, no matter how anointed you are. But you listen to another person. That is why, I don't know about you, but I've been to Canaan Land Altar, where Bishop Redemption Church is. I've been to Redemption Camp. On Sunday mornings, when people will leave Redemption Camp and go to Altar, so people will not leave Altar and come to Redemption Camp. Why? They don't just want to listen to Redemption. They want to see if they are here at the way. Other people don't want to see you anymore, you want to see your enemy. So you will see them rush. Somebody is going like somebody is coming like this. Why can't they just go to the church within their house? No. The same way here. Word of God church is here. So people will leave word of God. They are here and they will leave here and go to here somewhere. So when people will leave here there and come here. Why? No matter how you do, there is a people that will not listen to you. I get what I'm saying now. Comfort yourself. You are taught to a unique kind of people. Okay, and everyone is successful in ministry as long as you are like God. When a man is calling to ministry, he must understand he is calling to selfless, sacrificial service. Your focus cannot be carnal and mundane things. Your focus cannot be carnal and mundane things, no. It can't even be what you will get, no. You must understand in ministry that you don't need what you sow. You reap the reward of your service and labor. And it's God that rewards you, not men. Don't be thinking that because you give 10 naira, God must have to give you 30 naira. That is a bonsai scheme. That's MMM. That's not Christianity. Anytime we come promising people how much God can give them car and house, we'll be disappointed because God may not be interested in doing that. You just a man that is very eager to promise you all of those things. Tell the people the truth. God will destroy your life and bring you the good. You are rewarded by God in due time. And God is the one that chooses when to reward you. Okay? If you go against such a Babylonian system of commerce is colonizing you, whether you like it or not. It's not about what you will get. It is truly God that sends you, who will provide for you. God sends some people to the villages, others to the cities. Okay? God will even send you to certain places you cannot be rewarded. Many ministers today, when you invite them, they'll ask you, how much is your honorarium? What kind of hotel you will lodge with? What is this? What is that? What is that? What is this? I said, what kind of thing is that? The guy wanted to invite me, was asking me, Apostle, do you need escort? Do you need police escort in Abuja? So, are we coming to come and pick you from which side? No. You need police escort. You need this. I said, young man, this is how you make believers. You make people call us men of God, apostles. I'm just a lover of Jesus. I'm a boy of Jesus. I'm a friend of God. Don't mistake the supply of the grace. The grace, you see, when they want to ordain me today, they ordain me as a reverend. They can't ordain me. You don't ordain me an apostle. You are not the one that ordained apostles. No one is ordained a prophet and apostle. You don't ordain graces. You ordain bishops. You ordain deacons. You ordain reverend. If God will call you and give you a grace, apostle, teacher, evangelist. Are you getting what I'm saying now? I said, why do you need police and escort? Somebody after my life. I said, please just come. If you can just come, just like I just smoke you, if you look, I just come and carry you. These are the things that make men proud. You are the one that make us proud. Some of all those too many things that they do. If it is truly God that is calling you and sending you, there are 30 times you will send you to place where the honorarium will never be up to your transport, your labor. But there are places you do to the Lord, tell you to keep them the money back. I put anything, they give me money, envelope, I give you open it. As what I did, I just pray, I said, take it back. There are places you go to, you have to spend your money. You will spend your money. Don't be after the money of people. A man said, if somebody is after your money, it's because it's not interested in your soul. If somebody is after your soul, you won't be interested in your money. Any man that focuses on money, you forget about your soul. You that focus on your soul, forget about your money. It's God that rewards us. Many people now, when you want to invite them to a dinner, you'll find out. If you do not profit them, monetarily, they will not come. But is it truly God that says you should not come? Or is it because you don't realize that there is a better option in the flesh? Many more times, we must come to a point where our life must constitute sacrifice. We don't have to always get. We must learn to give. There are places I just go to be a blessing for the people. I'm not a poor man. Then why should I behave like a poor man? I must have to discuss as if I didn't want business with God. No. I didn't begin this journey to do business with God. No. No. I begin loving Jesus. My own intention is to see that a whole people, a whole nation, an whole army return back to God. That men return back to their first love. And people come to love God genuinely. That cannot be done when we focus so much on how much you can get and money. Of course, those things will come. But I find it even afraid to tell people the proceeds that come from ministry. Ministry will reward you, but don't put your eyes there. When you focus on money, you'll be frustrated as a minister. God is the one that will help you, but don't focus on how much you get from people, you'll be frustrated. A lot of times, the people that will reward you in the ministry are not even the one you are preaching to physically. No, I'm telling you, God is the one that sent men to reward you. There are people that send me money, I don't even have an idea where they are. I don't even know them. Like, literally, don't know them. Most of the people that you labor for will never do anything for you. That's why it's your reward. The reward comes. But it's not because you give somebody tender and you want to collect tender. No, don't do that. You can go for a meeting. The entire honorarium will give you there. Somebody in that meeting will be blessed and call you and reward you something that the entire congregation can never be able to do for the past 5 days for you. There are people that meet every day, influential people every day. One of them is enough, the entire church. You are after the souls of men, after the lives of men, let them pay their money. Forget about their money. If you have your own way, say, give to the body of Christ the Lord. Give. I was told of person that also that you never rejected any ministry. That is very hard. We have rejected a lot. And let me tell you, I don't know person else I did. Every ministry I accept. No one has seen, he has put to every more, he has put to most black men than any white man, and put to most white men than any black man. He do churches for people, not in just do that to them. He can come to a church and support them with heavy amount of money. That was a man that sounds selfless. I remember some time ago I was booked for a meeting, and a president called me. And he began to ask me a question. I was thinking to myself, as I said, yes. That's going to pay this, but you need to know how much you're going to have here. I said, you might pay it today to the rest of your life. And you need to know how much you're going to have here. I look at your hand. I said, President, you are part of the problem we have in the body of Christ. I never even knew there is something like that. I used to hear it from afar, I never knew it would happen to me. So ministers today discuss how much is the value. If it's not okay, they will not come. And after some, you tell you that you need to do this kind of soap, you need to carry them with this kind of car, you need to do it. See, those things are not necessary. As ministers, young ministers, help yourself. These things are not necessary. I know many people have been misused, many people have been taken advantage by people. Because if you do not discuss your process, of course, they can even come and I'm not a part of our mentor. They went to a place, the food they gave you was the food they shared with the congregation. They went to a place where I assure you, he's sleeping with an insect like that. It's true. It's part of what you face in ministry, but let me tell you, don't even be to look for comfort for yourself. Reject the need to bless people. No matter how much I tell them it's my honorarium, do you know that it's not sufficient enough? Men can never reward you for your service to people. It's God that can reward you. How are ministers rewarded? By passive value. Somebody can perceive your value and want you 100,000, another 150,000, another 30,000, another 50,000, another whatever, another 1,000,000, another 1,000,000,000. As you advance, God is the one that rewards you, not men. Don't look and set a value, set a price for yourself. No. Ask yourself, is that what God wants from you, or was that a system that you bought? David wake up and begin to number Israel. As he number Israel in the flesh, a plague broke out. Maybe some of the things you do are the reason why you lack relevance. You want to cover a meeting, you put money upon people. I tell sometimes, you ask me, how many people come to Israel and cater for? If you cannot cater for anybody, I can cover myself. I've been traveling alone, I don't really need you. No meeting I will go for, I won't have transport times two, whether for flight, whether for hotel. If anything come up, I can leave on my own. Ministers are not poor the way you are thinking. Maybe they present themselves poor, I'm telling you. I'm a master degree holder, my brothers. I will start PhD this year. I can decide to pick a work anywhere. I have a lot of business I'm doing. I don't need your money. But by the time a minister presents himself as gold, you need that 10 naira, that 5 naira that you have. They make people insult us. So anytime you see things, they remember the bad experience they have of a prophet that scammed them, or of an apostle that took away their money. You need to be able to be very, very careful. You must present the image of God with you. I told the prophet that that's a very, very corrupt system. And this is how many things are corrupt. As a minister, you will be rewarded according to the truth by God and the honor by men according to passive value. I don't know how much was Apostle Paul in the Bible on the Arion. I don't know how much was Apostle Peter on the Arion in the scripture. But I know that their service to God was effective. And what men give to them depend upon men. Even when God says they should come, they come on their own accord. When you have money in view, you need to call say you should come for a meeting. Because if people cannot cater for the money, you will not come. I'm telling you as a minister. The souls of men, there are any villages around here. Go there for evangelism. You don't need anyone around. Use your money, go there. When you are born here, we celebrate it today. Do you know how much we are born to use for crusades? We spend millions for crusades. I was at the Abon Ke final crusade in Lagos. That man spent millions. He gave a lot of money. Pastors, some of them eat the money. They eat it. They are born to read books. I give it. I have written a lot of books. I give them free. People call me. Apostle, how much do you sell the books? I say it's free. He say, hey, how is that possible? And you read the books, you have tremendous encounters, and they are free. People send messages today. We give this free. You think we do not know the law of commerce? We don't know that you can sell 15 books and get how many thousand? Sell 1,000 books and get or sell that? You think if I bring my books to this congregation, hundreds of people that are ministered today, almost how many of you, if they buy? How much is it? If you have 300 in the morning, if 300 people buy my building to 2,000, how much is it? But it's after money, not after the source of man. I pick a limitation of God when we put money in view to bless the life of man. You must always understand that your reward will come, but it will not come the way you are thinking as a minister. Okay? Anytime they invite you for a meeting, the most important is how will you come?
And where will you sleep? They have any place to sleep? Do the work of the missionary. I have done a lot of missionary work, but we go for retreat. I don't know many of you have followed us for a going to retreat. We sleep on the floor. I'm okay with that. It doesn't change anything about me. People travel all around the come, when they see me, specifically, is that you? I say, yes, it's me. I am a good leader. I lead by example. I will not go and hide somewhere who are praying. I will pray as they are praying. We will go to the bush and look for the stick to do the local way of cooking together. We will back in the street. It doesn't reduce anything from me. Humility will take nothing from you. In fact, many of you were nothing. God made you something. Why are you trying to make big deal of yourself? You're not. Forget about all the packaging we do of fruit. This packaging is so that people say, maybe this is why you should put any place anyhow. They snap all the time. When they hear the picture of the line online, you start putting the picture here and say, how to dress well. But these things are not worth add value to you, my friends. And the man began to discuss money and all the places in this room for the coffee. Top places. It is true, when you follow this thing, I'm telling you, people will undermine you. A lot of people will take advantage of you. Well, it is part of the price to pay as a minister. That's why I ask, why are you a minister? You need to be able to answer that question before you go into ministry. Why are you a minister? Is it to serve God, or to serve men, or to serve yourself? Very important. If you are serving God, behave like one. If you are serving yourself, let's know. If you are serving the body of Christ, let's know. Okay. As I conclude, I told you, when God sent a man, he will always reward you. Okay. Many of the things we see in ministry today is copy. People copy all kinds of things. Wrong mindset, wrong ideology, wrong systems of Babylon. Everything people copy is wrong. The pride, the arrogance, the whatever is very, very wrong. Many things have become so hard and tough on people. You say people should be humble, and you yourself are not humble. Well, humility is for you to be available to people that cannot be wrong. Can you? It costs us a lot. But let me tell you the truth. You truly want to play the body of Christ selflessly. Humility is key as a minister. Many ministers fall. And many are still falling because of pride. God can only replace you with somebody. There is one I call a love to mission with you, whether I like it or not. You may be at the center stage today, you will not remain forever. God will always place you higher and bigger than you. Okay? The danger of me and people right now is that we can do better than you. We can be better than you. As long as I'm able to repeat you and impart you. It's dangerous. I will be able to be comfortable and accept that. If not, I will want to suppress so that you don't rise. And that's evil. That's Babylonian. That's an Egyptian system. They fail and they believe. Many people have failed in school, failed in religion, failed in everything. And they believe that opening the church or ministries is an excuse. They are escaping. So they decide to open a church. And so they are doing their best to succeed by force. Another man said, you come to Port Harcourt to hustle. You do not come to Port Harcourt to preach. Now even Jesus will be a now what brought them to Port Harcourt is to hustle. So Jesus Christ is part of the hustle. They are not after the souls of men, they are after the hustle. That's why you see all kinds of ministry that does not represent God everywhere. No wonder many men are faith, many men are charlatans. God is going to judge a lot of people in the body of Christ. I don't get any men. I told you, before you meet a genuine minister, you must have met at least 100 faith ministers, because genuine people are very few. Everybody has a bitter tale story to tell about a minister that helped a pastor, a prophet either took money from them, or sleep with their sister, or something else. Why? Why must we have to live life like that? Giving ministers a bad thing is because people fail in life and they want to succeed in ministry. No. The God does not help you, don't have a ministry as a minister. Why are you a minister? You come to also, you come to push. You don't even know God that you're a professor.
Don't do this because people are doing it. Follow God. There are things that you know. You pull it from there. You pull them from somewhere. Let them away. You don't let them know you are under a Babylonian system of merchandise. You are using people as you are using the source of men to make money. You will not even be aware of most of these things because you are only colonized by the loss in your heart. Thank God this is Archbishop Church. I was with Archbishop some time ago. I assure you, most of these men were men that were men of prayer. They served God and served humanity in selfless. The reason why you said the question today was not because he was after your money. How much are you giving him? How much? You will ensure that he served you as he served God. He didn't start like that. He started from somewhere. He was always understand that he didn't see God. The man said God is a God of speed, he's not a God of rush. Many people just want to come up and just have viewers all around the world where I see. Today I have people coming from different countries. I don't even differentiate. Human beings are human beings, whether you are white, black, green, yellow, I don't care. Problems are problems. Problems are genetic. White people have problems, black people have problems, Japanese people have problems, green people have problems. Problems are all of color. I do young that for, I don't even have time for even the white people. I'm telling you the truth. You must understand that when your life becomes valuable, nobody cares about your color. You can be so ugly. As long as you have the solution, and if a picture means a fat figure of greatness, the things that buy money. When you have those things, every war, you say, all men seek for you. Everything is all men seek for you. As a minister, you must come to that point where all men will seek for you. It doesn't matter their color. You must start from somewhere. I have many times when I started, nobody knew me. Like nobody knew me. I was serving, nobody knew me. In fact, we didn't even believe we were anointed. There were men that were on the center stage. And I still know today, many people are hearing their voice will be silent very soon. Because God is still checking us. God is still evaluating us. That's why I do my best to put myself under subjection so that I will not also be a castaway. No matter how powerful I'm going to be, I can be cast away. I assure you. You must do your best. Start from somewhere. Don't just want to just begin to pray and go everywhere. You are sick. That desperation will lead you to hell. Start from somewhere. If God truly calls you, start from somewhere. Find men to serve. Serve men. Come under their children, you can come under their spirit. And after that, don't just have this eagerness to become president of the fellowship. No. Don't be eager to become president of the ministry. No. Start spontaneously. Okay. Like I told you, Archbishop Charles Sonner, today is the current president of National State, the Rangers like that. Ask yourself if God called you, or is it men that call you, or do you call yourself? If God is the one that called you, he will continue to grow you. Are you prepared enough to be sent by God, even if you are called? Are you truly prepared enough? If you are not, remain with the master. Remain at the master's feet until you are prepared enough to be sent. If you are prepared, you have to also ask yourself, what was the last instruction that God gave you for you to keep to it before you are sending out? If you truly are a genuine minister, you should be able to answer this question. Who called you? You called yourself or God called you or men sent you? What was the instruction that God gave you? This instruction I gave that will be guided in your life. Pray God to instruct you there. I know what I'm to do. I'm not a victim of some confusion, no. You must understand that your life must be guided by instructions and the principle of God. The young minister like you is seeking God and pursue to advance the kingdom of God. You must be careful of this prophecy. Many people are after being ministers to announce themselves. They are going to have challenge. So you do a meeting, you bring 14 ministers. Put all the great men that you think you know. You can't even honor them. You do meeting, you go and look for your man that you cannot honor. Don't know because I say minister should just come to your meetings and be humble enough for you. That means that you are going to go and bring everybody. You are sick. That is madness that I've seen in the pulpit today. Look for a minister you can honor. At every level you have, there is a minister within your level that is genuine enough that you can honor. Look for him. Don't go out there and be minister. That is why today I have to speak to people. Anything big. We have to be able to be strict. Why? Because everybody looks for cheap publicity. You don't know the neighbor your man has done to believe himself the devil he is today. You must be able to ensure that you don't just rush after them so that they can help you give you cheap publicity. No, no, no. Ask him, why should you do what you should do? Look at you, be suffering a lot because God did not send you, you sent yourself. I round up with this. I need you to know that a prepared man is only better than a prepared message. Every process the Lord is taking you through is to bring you to a point where you are prepared. So that as you are a prepared man, his kingdom can take all upon you any day and you can represent him right. Can you rise on your feet as you pray? As a God and say, Father, help me. I spoke to you as minister today because I know there's a calling of God upon each and every one of your life. I'm going to pray for everyone in the next few minutes. The release and impartation upon all of you. And I trust God that the heart of the Lord will guide you beyond the now. You are going to begin to journey the Spirit in every area of your calling to bring it to your level of functionality in God. I will pray and ask the Lord and say, Father, Lord, there's a prayer and the impartation I will give to you. May the Spirit of the Lord guide you. So that you don't be a failure to the kingdom of life. You should not be the reason why many people will say that God is bad. Ministers are bad. They don't believe in Jesus again. No. Shababala na kapa sabra kokobala de la kapa tapule de la kapa sabra na kapa la ria na kasaha. Shababala na kapa sabra de bala kule de la ria kapa na bando shabra na kapa la ria. Rapa tela, rapa tela, rapa tela. Shaba bala de kwa sabra kapa bala de la kapa bas kapa shaba bala de la kapa kwa sabra kapa la ria. Give me one, my life. Spirit of the living God, come and run my life, Yahweh. You will not run my life, I am Spirit of the living God, come and run my life, Yahweh. You will run my life, you will run my life, I am. You are the king.
Thank you. see my post in this life and the other. There's a calling of God upon your life. The mighty apostolic call upon your life. I cannot be fair.
Transferred to him. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.